What's up, guys? This is Tamil, and welcome to my channel. All right, so in today's video, I'm going to show you how to create a list in Aweber. So right now, guys, I have been building my list by putting out a lot of valuable content. So if you're on that route where you want to start building your email list, now's a good time to learn how to create a list in Aweber. So now, if you have an Aweber account already, then you should be right here, maybe at the dashboard. One of the first things that you want to do is you're going to go up to where it says Manage Lists. Once you hit Manage List, you're going to go here where it says Create a List. Once you're on this page where it says Set Up Your List, it's going to ask for two things. It's going to ask for your company name. You can go ahead and put your company name here. And then you want to go ahead and put your company website address. Once that is complete, then you can go ahead and scroll down to the bottom. Here you will put your sender name, which I already have, and you can also add an email here. All right, go to the next step. Now you're on the page where it says describe your list. All right, so this is the area where you want to describe, you know, or send something to the recipient if they choose to possibly cancel with your email. So the first thing it says, what would you like your name list to be? So we can go ahead and name this. Let's just make up something like start a blog. The next thing says, briefly describe the emails your subscribers are going to receive. Now, this is where I like to get a little bit tricky, and I like to put a message here that's going to convey to the recipient that they should kind of stay on the email list. So if you look down to the bottom, it says your subscriber will see this description, and you wonder where are they going to see it. So when I click on this, it says your subscriber will see this if they choose to unsubscribe from your list at a later time. So now, most people would probably describe what this list is about. So it could be, you know, tips and strategies on how to start a blog. But for me, instead of putting tips and strategies on how to start a blog, I'm going to say, wait, don't go yet, you will miss out. So let's put that in there instead. The reason why I like to put this here, guys, is because, like they said, this is going to go on the page when someone decides to unsubscribe to your list. So it's better to put a message there that will probably get them to stay on the list rather than putting a message that just describes what your list is about. So I like to put something a little bit different. Hopefully they'll see the message and change their mind or just decide to not unsubscribe altogether. So you can put whatever you want, but this is what I put in mine. All right, so let's go to the next step. All right, so on this page, it says approve your confirmation message. All right, so we already have English that's right here, and your subject line right here says confirm your subscription. Now, this is how this works. When someone subscribes to your email list, or maybe you're giving away a free offer, they're going to put in their name and they're going to put in their email address. When they do that, they will typically get a message in their email inbox wanting them to confirm that it's okay to get emails from you. So what I like to do here is you can choose any one of these. You know, you can choose the title, confirm your request for information, confirm your subscription, you know, confirm your, you know, you can make it personalized and you can have their name put in there. Doesn't matter what that is. What's important is that you put a message there that prompts them to confirm their subscription. So you can put a message that says anything like, you know, hey, thanks for subscribing to my email list, you know, or thanks for opting in. Here's your free offer for learning how to start a blog. It's a step-by-step guide. In order for me to know whether or not you want to get this offer, please hit the confirm my subscription button. So you're prompting them to hit the confirm my subscription button. And the reason why you're doing that is so when they hit that button, now you can start sending them follow-up emails. But guys, if they never go to their email address and hit that button, you will not be able to send them emails until they do so. And oftentimes people will, they'll forget to go to their email and confirm that it's okay to get, you know, emails from you. So that's what this right here is about. And so you want to go ahead and put a message there that prompts them to hit the confirm my subscription button so that you can begin to put them on your email list. Well, they're on your email list, but they have to confirm it so that you can start sending them follow-up emails on autopilot. So that's what that's about. So you can click this right here, edit it, and it's here where you can put a message for your recipient. Now, when you scroll down, you can put a signature there, and we can take a preview of it to see what it looks like. You can do a preview here. Well, it would be a preview if I put a message there. But now you're actually all set. This is pretty much all it takes to be able to create a list in Aweber. So we're just going to go ahead and approve this message by clicking this link. Now, it brings me back to this page, but what I'm going to do to confirm that I made that list is I'm going to go up here to Manage List, and I'm going to scroll down. I'm here on Manage List, and if you look right here on my list, it says right here, Start a Blog. And so I did create it. It is here. And so it says, wait, don't go anywhere. You will miss out. So that's my little message that shows up on the unsubscribe page. And so now I know that I created it. So now I can actually just click on this. And now that I've clicked on it, this is how it's going to look when you go into your list options. And that's right here. So now that we're in list options, I see the name of my list, and I also see my description, and I also see my name, and everything is here that I need. So now if you look here on the left side, you have ways in which you can personalize your page, and you have ways to look at the confirmation message, and you can edit the message. So let's just click on a few of these. Now, it takes me to this page, which is the company branding page. You can go here and you can start to brand your email. So the emails that you send, you can upload your company logo, or you can upload a picture of yourself. You can do a signature that's going to go in your email. This right here is just a dummy website that I just put up, just something there so you can look to see how it would, just to fill in this area so that I can click to the next page. Now, you can continue to fill this stuff out. You can add your social media links to the inside of the email that you send. And when you scroll down, you can go ahead and just hit the save button after you've put in all of this information or personalize it the way that you want. So you can go to this page and you can do all of this stuff, guys. Now let's check that confirmation page. Now, technically, had I put in some information here on the confirmation page, the information that I gave you, you would have all of this information here. And so what you can do is you can edit this at any time that you want. So you can edit that page. You can edit the subject line, whatever it is that you want to put here. And like I said, if you decided to personalize it by putting the person's name first, you can do it right here in this drop down. So you could say, Sally, confirm your subscription. So you would know that based on whether or not they actually entered their name during the opt-in. So on your homepage or whatever page that you have on your website or your blog, you should have an area for them to put their name and their email. All right, so now I'm not going to get too deep into this, but this area down here allows for you to be able to make some additional changes inside your email list where you can actually take off the double opt-in. And so if you know anything about double opt-in, sometimes people will have what we call a bridge page. And a bridge page is a page between the opt-in page or the landing page and the actual page in which they receive a message or the free offer. So sometimes you'll go to a website, you'll put your name and your email address in, and you think that as soon as you click enter, that the next page is the actual offer or the free gift that you want. And then what you end up seeing is a page with someone on there saying, hey, thanks for opting in. You know, go to your email list or go to your email and get the free offer I sent you. All right, that's called a bridge page. So what it is it's a double opt-in. And so you can actually take this off if you want to. You may have to call Aweber to be able to do so, but it's gonna be due to this confirmation right here. So what this allows is it allows for the person to bypass having to click the link that says confirm my subscription. So let's just say most people don't go back to their email to hit this button that says confirm my subscription. You've got them kind of like stuck. They're on the email list, but until they hit that confirm my subscription button, you can't follow up with emails. Well, the double opt-in allows you to take that off. So You can do that if you want to, but guys, I just want to show you how this is done right here. And you've got ways and options to, you know, customize and edit your list. All right, guys, so that is pretty much how you create a list in Aweber. I hope you got some value out of this video. It's really simple. It's easy. It takes a matter of just, you know, 3 or 4 minutes to do, and you can always go back in and edit that list. It shouldn't take very long to do. Make sure that you like, comment, and subscribe to my channel, because I will be putting out more videos just like this. Make sure that you hit that bell notification so you don't miss out on any episodes that I have and you're the first one to hear about them. All right, guys, thanks for watching this video. Check out more videos that I have right here, and I will see you on the next one.